Aloha, welcome to Kealakai the podcast. My name is Mutia Parasdita and I will be the host for today. I'm here with my co-host Eli Hadley. How are you doing, Eli?
Doing good, tired but good. It's a nice rainy day outside, makes me want to go lay down for a nap, you know.
That's awesome. Well, as we are all studying in Brigham Young University, Hawaii, we have been exposed with a lot of opportunities and cultures and everything. And we're so excited today that we have two people, Ching and Ice. How does this semester treat you guys?
It's, so far it's fine, but we are bracing for more challenges to come, but we can do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just in a mood that's so ready to go home for a vacation.
That's awesome. Like, that's the best time of the year, summer, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so a little bit about them. They are in the presidency of the Art Club, and it's a brand new club that probably never been existing before. I'm not sure about many years ago, but this is a brand new thing to Brigham Young University for spring semester. So we're so excited to talk about your club. And okay, tell us a little bit about you for those who doesn't know you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I am Isesario. I'm from the Philippines. I'm majoring in visual arts, graphic design. And this is actually my second semester. So not even 1 year yet.
That's great.
Yeah.
You want to start everything right away.
Yeah.
That's cool though.
He's a go-getter.
Good, awesome. Yeah, my name is Ching. I came here the second time and I'm majoring in communication. And right now, I work as a peer mentor. So Ice, that's actually how I met him during the mentoring session.
Okay, so when you mentioned about mentor, is it like an English mentor or?
So that's another side topic. So kind of gonna be an advertisement. Yale Peer Mentor Program is for senior student that kind of like mentoring the freshman student who just first came to this campus.
Oh, so introducing about this campus, where it's located, and then how does it feel like to be a new student? Wow, that's a really nice source to have on campus here, because I didn't have that when I first came here.
Me too.
It was during COVID. Mm-hmm. What about you, Eli? Did you have these kind of things before?
Not really, no.
Yeah, the EAL is actually for international student only.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's great. All right. So talking a little bit about the club, you're making an art club. But what kind of art you guys individually do?
Yeah, so me, personally, I'm not that good at painting or illustrating. So what I focus on is graphic design. That's why it's my major. So instead of drawing in a piece of paper using pencil, colors, painting, I'm drawing in a
digital
software where I can express myself, where I can do anything. I can design, I can illustrate myself, I can draw some figures, like those stuff. And that's why the reason why I took the graphic design.
That's awesome. Did you have like a prior experience before you came here? That's why you came up with this?
I already know how to do it because someone taught me back in high school. And since the time that he taught me how to do graphic design, I first started in vector arts. And after that, I just enhanced and improved myself by watching videos. Mm-hmm. And that made me realize that this is my passion and I want to pursue it in higher education.
Mm-hmm. That's cool. What about you, Ching?
Yeah, I agree with what he said. So my major is communication. So sometimes I think about speaking, is it art as well? And people might scare or shy to speak out. So for example, when they have the talent, they don't know how to spread it out. Mm-hmm. So in our presidency, we actually collect different style of art. So we have people like good at painting on book and have people good at kind of Photoshop. Have good people like good at communicate to public speaking. So we want to kind of like collecting different art, just kind of like in the place that we can collecting different people, have those different talented, and then we can learn from one another.
That's cool. I really like the way you said, like, communication is an art, because mm-hmm. I didn't think about that. I thought it's something that people naturally have because they were born with it, right? So what about you? Like, what kind of personality you have? Are you the type of person who speak a lot before, or this is something that you realize, okay, I can speak to people?
Oh, yeah. I remember that's kind of the backstory when I was a little kid. So, you know, when you're a little kid, your professor always likes to ask you, what do you want to do after you growing up? People always say, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a police, I want to be here, there. I always mention I want to be a host.
That's so great.
When I was 8 years old, I always like to practice talking by myself, like in front of the mirror. So by that time, I just realized how powerful the languages can be. And then since I become an EIL peer mentor as well, I realized how many people, they have so many big talents, but then just shy to spread out, shy to stand up themselves. So that is why the main reason I was able in this arts club, I want to encourage those introvert arts person to speak up themselves.
I love that. And I think it's so important, you know, expression is not limited to expressing yourself verbally, right? Not just through singing, not through anything like that, right? Of course, that is part of art. But like Muti said, communications is art. You know, anything can be art, right? And it's so important to have that expression because we need to feel like we can. Sometimes it takes more than words to show what we're feeling or how we want to make other people feel. So that's why I love art personally. But for the two of you, where does your inspiration come from? Like, do you have your own like a primary source of inspiration, or is it just from everywhere?
Is it for
how
this club?
How did you create this club?
Just when you're making art, but also for the club, we'd love to know that too.
Oh yeah, for creating art, I just, since I was a kid, I really want to draw. I really want to paint. I think art is my strength when I was a kid, but then when I grew up, I realized, oh, I want computers. I want to do IT. So when I'm senior high school, I took computer programming as my specialization. And I had a hard time. And that's the time when, as I mentioned earlier, someone taught me how to use Photoshop, how to design. So when I learned that, I realized it's a mix of my passion in computer and in arts. So that's where my inspiration came from. It's been my hobby since I was a kid. And as I grew up, I just developed it for myself.
That's awesome.
Yeah, actually, I like to paint as well. I do some painting when I kind of like super, super stressed, or when I just feel good about myself and I will start to paint something out. I do some oil painting, and I like to paint with my pencil, with my pen. I don't like to using pencil to paint at all because I hate repetitive. But then art for me just kind of a way to release my stress or just make myself feel good. But then connecting to communication as well, I feel like language is beautiful, just same as the painting, as long as they can express a feeling, express the languages. It's a beautiful thing. So that's why I start to love this kind of things.
I love that. And then for the club, what was the genesis? What planted the seed to want to start a club like this for you guys?
Yeah, that's a very fun story. Because last semester, because it's my first semester, last semester, and as I look around the club fest, I'm looking for something related to arts because it's my major. And as I look around, I don't see anything that is related to arts, or I don't see any arts club present here in campus. So I just kept that in my mind. I'm also planning to just do it last semester, but of course it's my first semester. I don't know a lot of people yet. I don't know the resources to take in creating the club. So as my mentor, Ching, talked to me about what's my vision in this school, or what do I want to achieve in the past or for the next few semesters. And I just remembered that thing that I just realized that there's no arts club. So I said to her, like, oh, I want to actually establish an arts club. I want to start one to not only help me express myself in this campus, but also to help other people, not only to express themselves, but also to improve their skills in art if they are not confident in their arts. This might be the place for them to show them, or show to all the people who they really are. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah, it totally makes sense. I just kind of like feel really touching in a point, because by that time, Ice is my mentee, and the last semester is actually my first time become an EAL peer mentor. So all of them are my first mentees. So I just feel like first just come together can be second, and it can be large or can be bigger. So when he told me about his goal, I said, just do it. I will tell you, go to the student leadership, ask every information, and then go to different department and figure out every information. And then the reason why I was kind of accept his invitation to become part of his presidency is because I saw he is a person that's actually put his thought to action. He's not those kind of person that say, I want to do this, and I want it. But he's actually ask and tell me, follow up with me and do it and actually create it. So I see this trend, and even this semester we have the Arts President Club for the meeting, training, everything. He always so active, so ready, so prepared. I was like, well, that is a leader we want. So, yeah.
Wow. Eli, awesome. When I heard about this, I'm like, okay, this is the kind of freshman that we want on campus, you know?
Exactly.
We need this kind of people around us who could like motivate each other to make our dream into reality, you know? Okay, for those who doesn't know Ice, he is the president of the art club. So if you haven't signed up, please join. Have you done your opening social yet?
It's coming.
Yeah.
In May?
In May 31st, but 31st. Since it's already late, we don't call it opening social anymore. We call it spring social.
Spring social.
Yeah, to be general.
Even better.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. But actually, whatever it is you have in plan, we are so excited about that. And we just have a question, actually. Like, how does your culture influence the art you make or the vision of this club? Because you are from different culture. You're from the Philippines from China, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, how does that work together?
Okay, so for me, it's very different because the arts in the Philippines, it's not really a big thing for a normal person there to pursue arts, because a lot of people think that there's no money in arts. You can't be rich in arts. You can't have a successful career in arts because it's hard, or there's no career, or there's no corporations or businesses that will accept you as an art student or an arts graduate. But then that made me more motivated in pursuing this arts and this visual arts, more especially the graphic design, because even though it's not popular in the Philippines, there's a lot of graphic designers in the Philippines. They are doing freelance graphic design for companies that are in US, that are overseas. So even if it's not being valued in the land itself, in the Philippines, graphic design is actually globally in demand as a job. So I think that culture made me more motivated in pursuing this and just continuing my love in arts.
Yeah, I like it. Actually, it's kind of similar in Asian culture because we consider doctor, lawyer, businessman will be those kind of like successful people. But at the same time, like art, it's really something that people respectful, and at the same time, people know how risky this job going to be. Either you got super successful or you end up super, super poor. So that's really a true train about that. And then another is like China have like a long time history. China have different arts and different style as well. And then I just feel like it will be really significant that we're able to express our culture through art as well. But then at the same time, it's just connecting to my communication parts too. I just want to kind of like shout out for those people who did not speak English as their first languages, or they're not really exercise these languages. Because I know, especially in our campus right now, have so many people like from China, Japan, and Korea. We never practice English back at home. Like we might learn that in the class, but we never actually practice. People have scarcity of speaking it. And then another quote that I like a lot from my roommate, what she say is, you never know how smart a person is when they speak their own languages.
I totally agree.
Yeah, that's what I think too. Sometimes people, just because they lack of language skill, they look a little way of dumb or less confident. But when they actually speak their own language, they are so amazing. So I just want to kind of shout out for people who kind of feel less confident, as those people have less confident in their art. Our art club is not a place to show off your skill. It's a place to gather everyone to learn different things from one another.
Well, I wish we could do a round of applause for that. honestly, I agree with you so much, Ching. And I think, you know, for me as someone who was born in the U.S., right? I'm American. I raised in an English-speaking country. English is my first language. That's a challenge that I don't face here, right? And so I think it's so important to be aware of that privilege for myself and other students who have my similar background. Because it's true, like, all three of you, right? You have all, you know, I think, unfortunately, there's still that perspective in the world that if someone can't speak a certain language the right way, then that means that they're not smart. But no, they're probably smarter than the person who thinks they're not smart, honestly. And we have to understand that as relative. And you know, our Father in Heaven created different cultures and languages for a reason, right? These things are beautiful. It's just that the world at the moment, English is more convenient for everything. But, you know, we need to be celebrating that. And I think art, you know, a culture's art, you know, it's pottery, it's sculpture, it's painting, right? It's all a way to show who they are, right? And by preserving that, but also adding new flares to it, new twists to it. Like I've seen Chinese paper cuts, right? But I don't know too much about Filipino art, but I think, you know, the beauty of the Philippines can be shown through our club. So can the beauty of China, the beauty of Indonesia, the beauty of, you know, so many other countries as well.
Yeah, everywhere.
That's so awesome. And you've talked a lot about kind of the mission of the art club is to bring people together culturally and to feel, just have a safe place. Could you talk more about the mission of the art club and, you know, how it's going to hopefully keep on going for years to come?
Yeah, so when we are just planning for the arts club, Ching asked me to prepare a purpose or a mission and vision for this club. And that made me very like anxious because I haven't done it before. I never created a mission before. And as I took the class of President Kawe, the Holokai class, student development, they mentioned that in creating a mission and vision, we should all not just look to ourselves on what can this the club do for us or what can the people do for the club. It's what can this club do for other people. So what can this organization do for students here in BYU Hawaii, or even here in Oahu, or here in Hawaii, or in the whole world. So as I think of that, I just thought that I want this club to help the students and faculties of BYU Hawaii to express their culture, their own culture, through arts without being shy, without being afraid. So just express themselves, whatever form of art, even if it's 3D, if it's 2D, whatever depth, whatever style do they use, it's a form of art. Even if it's a communication, even if it's visual, even if it's verbal, all of those things are part of arts. When we had our first presidency meeting, I told them that I don't want this club to just stay as a club. I don't want this for the people to just see it as a club. I want the people to see it as a community of creativity, where they can share their imagination, where they can express themselves, they can express their emotions. So that, for me, it's hard to really put into words on what is our vision with this club. It's just so broad and it's so exciting.
Okay, so you mentioned a lot about your club being a safe space for everyone to explore, even if they're not really good at it. And I think it's a really, really nice vision and mission. Okay, and how are you gonna put it in a package? Like, I mean, what kind of activities are you planning to have ahead?
Mm-hmm. So since we're the beginning, so we're short on budget, mm-hmm. and then the very first thing that the first coming activity, we were planning to do some origami and then kind of like teaching everyone to do some rolls together. And then after, we kind of like do some ice break to kind of like show up their different talent or just like share their taste. And then other thing that we want to using social media as well. As what I just mentioned about like people have different talent, like for verbal, for cutting, or just like put a magazine on the top or something, just any decoration. So they can kind of like screenshot of the piece of work, and then they can share with us and we can highlight their awards. And that way we can post it. Everyone can receive different perspective in a way that we can encourage one another. So we're for sure to keep this environment healthy and safe.
Awesome.
Okay, so I think there are a lot of things that could happen in the art club. And then have you ever thought about collaborating with other clubs? Because you do a lot of design. Mm-hmm. Some clubs need a cool design to make their activity more interactive. Or some clubs need, okay, I need people from public relation or whatever it is who's like really capable to speak. And then, okay, I'm going to grab it from the art club. Do you have something in mind like that?
Yeah, we are very open in the idea of collaborating with other clubs, especially since we are arts club. It's very flexible. We mm-hmm. could collaborate with any other clubs in the campus, even if it's not really related to arts. We can really like connect it to them. And not only that, we are also, since it's arts club, arts is not only limited to visual arts. It also extends to performing arts and other kinds of arts. So maybe someday we could have a lot of people who's interested in this club to show their talents, not only in visual arts, but also in performing arts. Maybe you could use it in culture night.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. And is there anything that you might feel people need to know about the art club that they never know? Because some people are like, okay, I'm not into art person. Mm-hmm. How does this art club benefit me?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I believe everyone have a taste of beauty. everyone wants something that are pretty. So as long as you see something pretty, you already get benefit. Right. And what we consider about pretty is something that people put on effort and that have their own spirit in it. And then when they're able to confidently share their talents, people will receive this pretty, and then they can know, oh, that can benefit me, if that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. That makes so much sense. And I feel like every time, the whole time you guys share about the art club, it makes me feel like, okay, I have something to offer. You know what I mean? I hope that's what all the listeners feel every time when they listen to this podcast. Mm-hmm. And I, do you have any hope for this club?
Of course, we have a lot of hopes for this club.
Yeah.
And hopefully this club is doesn't only like stay here in campus. Maybe this club could also collaborate with other clubs, like with other arts society or arts community outside campus. And that could be a possibility in the future. But for now, our hope is just to, for the people to see their, see themselves as an artist, not only because they know how to draw, that not only because they know how to do pottery, they know how to do graphic design, but it's because they are created by God and they are a masterpiece. So we as a humankind ourselves are arts already. So we hope we see that in ourselves, that we were something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, kind of go along with what I just kind of mentioned about we are already pretty ourselves. We are a good work already. So we kind of just keep mentioning about those people who are less confident. So that's what art club want to, the ultimately goal, want to kind of encourage people just have confidence, have feeling good about themselves. And then through art, I feel like two languages is something that can connect in different culture. It's art and music. So I think if we try to provide a good environment within the art club, and people can slowly feel comfortable and share themselves and feel confident amongst themselves. And then since they have confidence in themselves, they can create a bigger work and then they can do more things for the community.
Yeah. Well, it's amazing to see like how every single person in this world are creators. They can create differences in life. They can create something amazing that many people haven't thought of. That's why we have a lot of amazing artists, and we hope that we will grow that confidence from the people in the club and then all those people who see it from the outside. And okay, before we come to an end about our podcast, do you guys have something to say or word of wisdom of the day?
I didn't prepare for this.
For the word of wisdom, I just really want to reclaim everyone. You are so amazing. Feel good about yourself by doing everything that you feel good about yourself. Because I know so many of you are struggling of your beauty outlooking. And so many of you are struggling of the talent that you have. And so many of you just struggling with a lot of things that you feel you're not good at. But I just want to tell you are pretty, you are amazing, and you are confident. By joining art's warm community, you can feel out a safe environment and there start to find your confidence.
Yeah, you got yours now?
Yeah, I got mine now.
All right.
And for me, I think my takeaway from this conversation, since we're talking about arts, we're talking about communication. She's a communication student, I'm an art student. I think from what we have what we talked about, I realized that art is a form of communication, and a communication is a form of art. So it goes either way. So as we just express ourselves through arts, we can communicate to other people, even if we don't have the same culture. And if we keep on communicating with other people, we can also create art by just those conversation that we had, just like this conversation. It's already an art.
It is. Thank you so much for the reminder. I think that's something that we all need to realize in this life, you know, everything is a form of art. And I hope all of you realize how important you are and how you can contribute in every single thing you see in this life. All right, so I think we're gonna wrap this podcast up. Thank you so much for coming. I'm Mutia Barasdita, and thank you for listening for the Kayala Kai the podcast.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.